Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Gaming on Caffeine. My name is Isaac, and welcome to some more Prison Architect. It's been a while. We did play this game, I think, about 6 months-ish ago. We played it around the time that it officially released. It came out of beta, and we did a little mini-series on it back then. Recently, I've seen some other people playing it. I've seen some new stuff, and I've had a real hankering to get back in and build another prison. And so, here we are. We're going to give it another go. We're going to start with a brand new prison. We're going to keep it male. We normally go with the default warden here, the most balanced individual on the planet, but I've done a bit of reading of all of the other warden bios, and I've kind of narrowed it down to two wardens that I really like the sound of. There is J.W. Periwinkle, and by the way, when I say like the sound of, it has nothing to do with their names, although J.W. Periwinkle is a phenomenal name. But J.W. Periwinkle grants the ability for guard dogs to have a 50% chance of fully uncovering any tunnels they detect. So whenever your guard dogs are just walking around and they sniff out or like discover a tunnel of some kind, because usually they'll be walking up and down and they'll just kind of pop up with the little tunnel icon, and with JP Periwinkle, when they do that, they have a 50% greater chance of actually uncovering the full tunnel and showing you which cell it's associated with, instead of having to go and look for that cell individually. I also kind of like the sound of Safara Aknova. I'm not quite sure if I'm pronouncing that right, but she gets a small cut of the resale value for each piece of contraband found. So whenever we find, like, I guess poison, most likely cigarettes, alcohol, all that kind of stuff. I don't know if we get a resale value for like poison and pickaxes. I would assume we also do, but I'm not quite sure who's in the poison buying market or if that's even legal. But we get a small kickback from that, and prisoners found with contraband will be fined directly from their savings. So prisoners will of course work in like the workshops or in the laundry and do all kinds of stuff to earn money, and we can fine them directly if we find them with contraband. So I'm kind of torn between these two. I kind of like the sound of Safara's system more, but I think the JP Periwinkle might be more useful for figuring out when people are going to try and escape, because that is like one of the biggest things in this game, is stopping your prisoners from actually escaping your prison. And so I think we're going to go with JP Periwinkle. We're going to make sure the prison is a large prison. Fog of War, yes. Forests, lakes, and buildings, I'm not going to have on. I had all of them on, I think, last time we played. And it just kind of takes up parts of the map. Like, especially lakes, they just take up big areas of map that you can't use. And you just kind of have to build awkward prisons around them. And so we're not going to have any of those on. Failure conditions, yes, we want to be able to lose if we go bankrupt or if too many people die or escape, etc. Gangs, I'm not too sure on yet. Some prisoners will arrive with gang allegiances and will attack rival gang members on site. Extra challenge. We are going to have events. So events just add like a little bit of randomness. Certain things will happen. Things might catch fire. Prisoners might get sent to your facility from another facility. Certain things might get banned by local authorities. All kinds of stuff like that. So we're going to have that on. Weather and temperature is actually, I guess, somewhat new, because it wasn't here the last time I played it. I went back and checked my video and this option wasn't there. But essentially, it adds changing weather, which looks pretty cool. But it also adds a temperature element to the game, where the temperature of your prison varies over time, and so like in the winter it'll get really cold and you have to make sure that you have radiators and hot water pipes and water heaters around your prison to make sure your prisoners don't riot, don't get angry, don't get frustrated. And the same is true in the opposite. You know, if it gets really hot, your prisoners are also going to get angry. So we're going to add temperature on. Obviously we're not going to go with unlimited funds. The only one that I'm a little iffy on is gangs, because it is basically just people attacking other people because they're in gangs. You know what? We'll do it. We'll go for it. It says extra challenge. I'm not really that great at this game anyway, but we'll see how it goes. We will hit play. Oh, look at this. The thing is massive. We've got all this space. We've got $30,000. I'm not quite sure why we start with $30,000 and $35. That seems like a bit of an odd starting value, but I will take it. Oh, it's because $35 is our original cash flow. So we get that $35 for starting. I'm not quite sure. Anyway, we got all our workers, we got the delivery area, the garbage area, and our first set of supplies are coming in here. Right now, over here on the left, we have our to-do list. We've got the CEO's letter, which we will just instantly delete. It's just introducing us to the game and saying hi and all that kind of stuff. Welcome to your new prison. And here we have our to-do list, our list of things to do, our list of grants. Right now, we are going to receive 8 prisoners tomorrow morning at 8 a.m. I don't want to do that, so we're going to go straight into intake. And for now, I'm going to set this to filter capacity, because we don't really want to be taking in any prisoners until we have somewhere to put them. Like, if they arrived right now, we would just be in complete chaos because we don't have any guards, don't have anywhere to put them. And so for now, we'll just set it to filter capacity so they will only arrive if there is somewhere for them to go. We might have to tweak that a little bit because if we go over to grants, I'm pretty sure, yeah, the basic detention center grant wants us to build a holding cell. And so the first set of prisoners that we get, we will take out this grant, by the way, but the first set of prisoners that we get are all going to go into a holding cell, which I'm fairly certain doesn't count as, like, we don't have that capacity to hold them. Under this, it doesn't count as capacity, does the holding cell. It's just a place to put them whilst we wait for more space. But essentially, for those of you who are unfamiliar with Prison Architect, we are going to build our own prison. And these grants are essentially like quests. They're stuff that we can do to get more money. And it's like a checkbox of things that we should do as we go through and unlock the prison. A lot of them give you money up front, like this one here gave me $20,000 right out the gate. And then once I've completed it, I will get a further $10,000. And to complete it, I have to build a holding cell, build a shower, a yard, a kitchen, a canteen, hire at least 2 guards, and hire at least 2 cooks. So, let's jump into planning mode here real quick. I'm thinking that my prison is going to start out something like this. I kind of like the things to line up. I really like that this lines up here. It lines up over here. That gives us, I would have preferred a double door here. I like the large jail doors, but because the center is kind of there, we're probably going to have a single jail door that's like the entrance to our prison. And then for now, let's just have it. It's going to look something like this. It's going to be a big square for the time being that looks something like that. I might tweak that, and I definitely don't want that to be there. I want it to be there. We are going to tweak this a little bit because before we even start building anything, I kind of want to plan this out a little bit. So we do have to have a holding cell. The holding cell needs to be a minimum size of 5x5. It needs to be enclosed by walls, have a toilet, a bench, and be indoors. So if this is going to be 5x5, can we not plan this out? Oh, that's really, really annoying, but essentially, let's have a look here. What we'll do is we will we'll use pathways for now. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5x5. It's got to be that big. The walls, of course, got to go around it like that. Then next to this, we need to have a shower, a yard, a kitchen, and a canteen. So I'm thinking for now we'll have this as like a shower, so we'll have like a little door there. We'll have a door there. That's going to be our shower. We don't really need this, I guess, so we'll get rid of that. There's obviously going to be a bit of a hallway. I think I might bring all of these forward by one. Something like that, just because I don't really want the hallway to be any wider than 3 wide. And especially once we get out of this like initial building, all of my hallways are probably going to be 2 wide. I don't like using the 1 wide hallways because the prisoners get so cramped and then get so frustrated that they cause riots and all kinds of stuff like that. So for now, we're going to start off with a 3 wide hallway, and then we'll probably, when we build the new building over here, do something like this. It'll kind of come out and then continue on down like that. And then from then on, it'll be like a 2 wide corridor. And then the rest of the prison will just use 2 wide hallways. But for now, we've got our holding cell, which is a little bigger than it needs to be, but that's fine. We've got our showers. That's where our shower's going to go. We need a canteen and a kitchen. So what I'm thinking is we kind of just cut this down the middle. I don't think there are any specific size restrictions on how big these need to be. No, the kitchen and the canteen can be any size. And so I think for now, we'll do something like this. It's kind of annoying me that this doesn't have like a perfect center. And so what I think I might do is just bring like the whole building in by one like that. And I'm not on walls, I'm on pathways. But if we do something like that, now we can have a bit more of an even canteen and kitchen, which, I mean, doesn't really want to be the case. It probably wants to be something more like that because we want to have a bigger canteen than we do kitchen. So that was a little bit pointless, but we'll leave it like this. We'll get rid of this over here. And for now, this looks fine. So kitchen, canteen, shower, holding cell. And then for the yard, I think for now, we'll just have like this over here. We'll have a really basic yard, and then we'll probably get rid of it like almost as soon as we start to expand and put a bigger one somewhere else. But for now, we'll have a yard right about there. We'll put the door there, and that looks pretty good. I kind of like that. I want to have the door there opposite this one, and I'll have the door here opposite that one. I kind of like that. So we'll grab our foundation. There's 2 options here. You can either build out of brick or out of concrete. I always build out of brick, and so I think just to be different from the last time I played this game, we will build out of concrete. We don't actually have to build this, although I have put walls down. This is going to be outside. It's going to be fenced off. So we'll hit play here. Our workers are going to get straight to work. We will also have them build some fence around on this side. Perimeter wall? No, here we go. Fence is what we want. So our fence come all the way around like that. I'm fairly certain certain that we can allocate this as yard straight away. Yeah, because yard doesn't have to be inside, unlike a lot of the other stuff. The yard does not need to be on the interior for it to work. Also, I'm going to turn automatic light placement off. This is something that I didn't do last time. And they put lights down in the stupidest of places. Like, there'll be too many lights. They'll be off-center. They will look ridiculous. And so we're not going to let the workers decide where the lights go. We're going to put our lights in manually. That's going to be beneficial in a few ways. One, it's going to look a bit better. And two, if you let them do it on their own, they put down a lot more lights than are necessary. And that increases the amount of power that your prison uses. Speaking of which, we do need a place to put our utilities. I haven't talked about utilities yet. We do need power and water. We have been given a power station and a water pump kind of free of charge here right off the bat. This does require an entrance though, so let me quickly throw that right about there so this building will actually form once that door gets put in. Whilst they're doing that, I think for the time being, we'll probably have like a little outhouse just next to the prison where all of the utilities are gonna go. And I kind of like the idea of having a one, like, wide gap between some of my prison blocks. It's not going to be very space efficient, like, that is just, like, a complete waste of space. But I kind of like the way it looks. And so I think when I expand my prison out, it's going to be made up of kind of blocks like this. It's going to be a very blocky prison. But I kind of like the idea of going, like, leaving a one wide gap like this. You know, kind of having a prison that looks something like that. You know, maybe push this out a couple more blocks like that, get rid of this. And then maybe have, like, you know, another block that's over here and looks something like, I don't know, this, but then maybe comes down over here like that. You know, this is just a rough outline. This is not going to be what my prison looks like, but I kind of like the idea of having this one block gap between everything. Of course, that wouldn't be it, but I like the way it looks. And, you know, then we can just put like a little corridor that connects up the two like that. And that's what I'm thinking of doing for my prison. I'm not quite sure if that's where I'm going to go with that. We might change our minds if it becomes like really space inefficient, but for now, we will work on what we have, and I think we will set our guys on building something over here. The actual utilities are 3x3, so they take up like a 3x3 space, and then the power station can be expanded upon with capacitors going all around it. So we want to make sure that the room is at least 5 wide. Right now I think it's 6. Let's see here. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, so what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna bring this back down by one like that, and that is gonna be like our little utility outhouse for the time being. So again, we'll build our concrete. I've got to make sure to click concrete every time, because otherwise my prison is gonna end up looking like half concrete, half brick, and it's gonna look absolutely horrid. But we'll leave that there. We'll get them working on that. We'll stick down, I guess, just like, do we need a staff door or a prison door? I think we can get away with just a staff door. If we put it right there, none of the prisoners should be allowed out through this door anyway, and so therefore shouldn't have any access to any of the utility stuff up here under any circumstances. So we'll leave that there, and we'll start putting down some concrete walls over here. We're gonna have them down all around like so, and then we can actually start allocating these rooms as their specific rooms. So we're gonna have a holding cell be right about here. We're gonna have the shower on this side here. We're gonna have the canteen be this big room over here, and then we're gonna have the kitchen over here. Do I want to change that? Do I want it to mirror this? I kind of do. Can I stop this building? I think I can if I right click. Yes, I'm gonna cancel this, and I'm gonna move that wall over by one like that, just to make the kitchen a little bit wider. Not because I think the kitchen needs to be a little bit wider, but just because I think it looks a little bit more visually appealing if this thing is like completely symmetrical. So we'll leave that there. We can get rid of pretty much all of the planning now. We don't need any of that stuff anymore. This is all set up and running. Let's put down our generator and our water pump. So we'll have the power station right about there. We'll put the water station on the other side of the room, I guess, there. Actually, no, you know what? We'll put it. Do I want to put it there? We want to leave room around the outside of this power generator for more capacitors, but I'm thinking we've got room for like extra stuff here. And so what I'm thinking is if we need another power station, we might put it there later on down the line. And that gives us a nice amount of room to put more capacitors around it. So I think we'll put the water station there. That gives us a bit more room later on down the line for the capacitor. The power station is online. The water pump is instantly online. You can see it's kind of connected right there. We do need to run some power cables down and through our prison. One thing, or one like big mistake that I usually make is just having a mess of power cables. And I want to try and keep both my power cables and my pipes looking as neat as possible. I don't want to just have like a massive mess of cables and pipes underneath my prison like I normally do. And so I'm going to try wherever possible to ensure that all of my pipes kind of go in the same block as my cables like this. We're gonna have pipes go all the way along there, and the cables go underneath it. We do want to make sure that large pipes are never under prison cells, because if you have a large pipe running underneath a prison cell, like we kind of do here, this is a large pipe that's connected to a holding cell. People aren't going to spend that long in our holding cell, so I don't think it's going to be too big of a deal. But if you have large pipes going through a normal prison cell, then prisoners can use them very easily to tunnel out and escape. So we want to make sure we don't do that. We want to make sure that we use the smaller pipes for connecting to actual prison cells. But for now, we've got all of these little red triangles telling us that these rooms are not yet complete. Because right now, this room is not enclosed by a door, it doesn't have a toilet, and it doesn't have a bench. So, all of these rooms do require doors. The holding cell could just have a jail door. The shower, I don't think needs a door. I think we can just leave the shower as it is. I don't think one of the requirements there is it has to be inside. It's not. It just has to have a shower head for it to classify as a shower. The kitchen needs to actually be a full kitchen, because right now this is not part of the kitchen. There we go. That can have a staff door on it. We don't want anybody who is a prisoner going into the kitchen just yet. Later on down the line, we can run programs that teach the workers how to work in the kitchen. But for now, we only want our hired chefs in there, which we should probably actually hire. And you know what? We'll hire our guards as well. And you know what? It's 1 p.m. We will go back into prisoner intake here. And tomorrow, we will take in all 6 medium security prisoners. So I'll say all available. I don't want to take in any minimum security yet, just because I don't want to have a mixture of prisoners in the same place. I want to kind of have dedicated areas for minimum security, maximum security, and medium security. Because when you put them together, if you put like minimum with maximum, or even minimum with medium security, they tend to start fighting, and people tend to get angry, and then people die, and there are riots, and it just becomes the biggest mess in the entire world. And so for the time being, we're going to leave that as it is. The canteen needs to have a serving table, a table, and a bench. So, let's go back to objects. We want to have a serving table, which hopefully will fit right there. It does, perfect. As for a table, we can put that, I guess, maybe like there. Because I want to make sure, I also want to try and make this as efficient as possible. So we'll have like one there. One there, they can sit either side of that table on those benches. And I think we'll do the same, like, here and here. That's not too close. Like, these aren't back-to-back. But that gives us capacity to hold about probably, like, 12, maybe, prisoners. I'm not quite sure how many can sit on either side. Probably about 8 before people start to get angry. If you try and cram prisoners in, they do get pretty annoyed. But this will work fine for now. Whilst we're a small prison, of course, eventually we'll have to get a much bigger canteen, a much bigger kitchen, much bigger showers, and much bigger everything. But for now, let's go ahead and let's throw down. We'll put like a jail door on here as well. We don't really want the prisoners going outside into the yard without permission, so we'll put that there. The shower needs a shower head. We are taking 6 prisoners in, and so for now, I think I will just put 6 shower heads in like so. Actually, you know what? Just to be on the symmetrical side, we will put 9 shower heads in like that. And then we'll just put like a drain under. Do I want to put a drain under each of them, or do I just want to put a drain by the door? If you put a drain directly beneath the shower, that will stop water flooding out. But we can also, I think, just put one. You know what? We'll put it under each shower head. Just to be on the safe side, we will put one underneath each and every shower head. Later on down the line, we probably won't do this, especially when we start making like 50, 60 showers. We'll probably just have like drains at the door. But for now, I'll just put it there because it might flow out, and I don't want the water flowing out of the shower into the rooms down here. We do have to make sure we stay on top of the lights. Right now, our prison is in complete darkness, and so what we'll do is we'll put one there, we'll put one there, and we'll put one in the middle just for safety's sake. This is not going to be quite central, which is really going to annoy me, but for now, oh, do you want to put 2 in there? I don't really want to put 2 in there, so I'll put one just a bit off-center, just to annoy anybody watching who likes things to be symmetrical, and then we'll do the same thing over here. We'll put one there, and then we'll put one there, and that should be fine. You can see the light there is kind of fine. It's not too dark, and now finally, we need to get our kitchen up and running, and we need to get our holding cell up and running as well. So we need a cooker, a fridge, and a sink. Let's have a look. Fridge can go, I guess, like right about there. The sink can go maybe there, and then the cooker can go like that. Again, all of this stuff is probably going to get moved as soon as this basic detention center grant is complete. You don't want to go too big too quickly. I've done that many a time before. I've tried to build the biggest prisons right off the bat. And your money does not go as far as you think. Like, we have $34,000. That would, look how small our prison is. We have $34,000, but that is not going to go very far whatsoever. You can burn through that incredibly quickly. For example, if I just try and build a big building here, you know, that's going to cost me $20,000 right off the bat, which is, you know, 2/3 of our money. So we do have to pace ourselves a little bit. We have to start with these smaller rooms and these smaller prisons and then kind of expand outwards as we complete these grants. But anyway, back to the holding cell. We need a toilet and a bench. So we'll stick a bench down. I'll put down 2 benches just because we have like 6 prisoners, and I don't think that all of them are going to be able to sit on one bench. But for the time being, we are going to stick with just the one toilet. We'll put it right about there. I did want to make sure it wasn't directly above the pipe. I don't think they're going to break out of the holding cell, but they could, and I don't want that to be a thing that happens. So let's hook all of these shower heads here up to the pipe system, and then let's hook all that up to this water pipe here. That looks cool. All right. Also, we need to hook it up to the sink. So let's just do, I guess, like this as well. Sure. That should work fine. And we are pretty much good to go. We are ready to start accepting prisoners. We completed the grant. We now have $44,000. And we can start looking at some other grants now, because there are actually quite a lot of grants that we've got to go through. So, administration center. Every prison project needs a functioning administration facility to ensure things run smoothly. So we need to build 2 officers, hire a warden, unlock finance, and hire an accountant. All right, we'll take that. You can only take out 2 grants at any given time, so we can select another one. For now, I think I'm just going to leave this as it is, because I don't think that we're going to complete any of these relatively soon. So for now, we'll just focus on building the administration center, and I think, unlike what I've done in the past, I think I want to kind of have this like this, like, outhouse here. I want to have it as a completely separate building. And also, we didn't put lights in here either, so I'll put one, like, I guess there and maybe there. Can I put one there? Blocked? Why are those? Oh, no, there we go. So I'll put one above each of these. I'll put one there and there. Cool. All right. So I think that I want my administrative wing to be like a completely separate building to the rest of the prison. Usually, I build it in, and there'll be like an office that's just surrounded by prison cells, and I don't really like that. And look at that. We're out of... Whoa. Did I dismantle those? I did not mean to dismantle those objects. What is this? Or did they take them down? What is this? What? Did they garbage them? They put them in the garbage? What did I click? I have no idea what I clicked, but we're gonna have to build this back again. What the heck? All right, we'll put those back. That cost us way more money than it should have done, but that's fine. We'll put that there. And then down here, we are gonna have our administrative wing. So it needs to be, I think we'll have it come like down like this. It needs to be at least 6 wide, because officers have to be 4x4. So if we do that, that leaves space for like 4x4 in the middle there. And then we'll go 1, 2, 3, 4, wall. So that's gonna be the wall. And then we'll go like 1, 2, 3, 4, wall. And then just for safety's sake, we'll go 1, 2, 3, 4, and wall like that. Okay, so we want to make sure the rest of this is filled in like that. So we have a nice big area for all of the officers to go. And then we, I think this is new since last time I played as well, the quick build feature. I don't know if that's always been there. I'm fairly certain that the clone tool used to be something you had to unlock through bureaucracy. Like, you had to get a warden, and then you had to kind of like research, in air quotes, because you don't actually have to research. You just click on it, and then like a little timer ticks down. But I think, how has that got messy already? Are we buying some really dodgy concrete? What happened there? Flipping egg. All right, we need. Let me get an object. Let me put like a staff door right about there. But yeah, I'm fairly certain that the clone tool used to be something that you had to buy and then unlock through bureaucracy, so through the warden, whereas now you can just quick build a lot of stuff. So like an office, a shared cell, a basic cell, a solitary cell. You can just clone all kinds of stuff right off the bat, which is nice because it means you don't have to like individually make each cell, which looks exactly the same. Is this going to work? Is this going to like fill in like an actual building? No? What? What? There we go. Sometimes it's a little weird like that. I have been playing a bit on my, off camera, and it does do that from time to time. It, like, there's like, a few bugs where it just kind of sticks around in build mode for a little while. But we'll do this 1, 2, 3, 4. We'll put another one there. And then 1, 2. Is my math just completely wrong there? 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. It is. Wow. Okay. So let's put a wall there, and then let's bulldoze these. Yeah, okay, cool. And then we can just go to quick build, and we can just throw down an office like this. We can just put an office directly in there. I believe we can use R to rotate it. We can, so we can just have the office that looks something like that. And that's kind of almost perfect. It does have that door on already, which we don't need. But for like this one here, we can just go boom, office is built. Boom, office is built. And then for the last one, which, oh, they can't get in there because the door's not there yet. But that's fine. They should be able to get through as soon as that door gets in. Did that middle one not get put down? Didn't. What the heck? Come on, guys. Speed it up a little bit. They should be putting this stuff down. For some reason, it didn't want to put stuff in there, and we didn't put it in here. But once this is done, once you've actually put in the first desk and the filing cabinet, we should just be able to clone the interior sides and without the door. Yeah, there we go. So now we can just go back to the quick build tool, clone. We can grab this like that, and we just go boom and boom. There we go. All right, that's going to be 3 officers. We do need to hire a warden, so we will go ahead and hire him right off the bat. We can't use our bureaucracy tab until he has an office, but he does now have an office. So this is where we unlock a bunch of stuff for our prison. So right off the bat, there are like all of the key people who also require offices, like the finance lady. We have security, maintenance, the legal team, education, health, and psychology. So the quest wants us to do finance, so we'll unlock finance first. We can then like do micromanagement. We can click as many of these as we want. So I'll actually, I'm just going to click on all of these because they're not too expensive right off the bat. That costs us about 3,000-4,000, and they're just going to queue up, so they don't work simultaneously, unfortunately. He has to work through each one individually, so he's going to approve the finance woman or hire the finance. I'm not quite sure how he is, what he is doing right now to get finance up and running, but the warden, he's going to sort out finance. Once finance is done, he's going to sort out maintenance, then legal, then security, and et cetera, et cetera. Cool stuff. We do want to make sure that we keep putting lights in all of these rooms. So back to object, lights. Let's make sure that each one of these officers has a light. Again, there's no central point in these 4x4 rooms, which really annoys me. But for now, we'll put all that there. Apparently, he's researching. Yeah, okay. So he's researching how finances work or how the legal team works. Let's try putting lights in here again. But this time, you know, maybe not destroying all of our equipment in the process. There we go. Okay, so that's now up and running as it should be. We can't put any lights in the yard, but that's fine. We also can't deploy our units yet. We really need to get this up and running pretty quickly because I want to be able to deploy my guards. Like, I want to have a guard in that holding cell at all times to make sure that nobody tries to dig out. But for now, this is working well. And at this point, there's not a whole lot we can do apart from wait until the prisoners arrive in the morning. And so what I think I'm going to do is plan out what my first, like, block of cells is going to look like. So, like I said, I kind of want to go one out from the last building. So we're going to have something that looks like this. And it's going to be pretty big. Like, maybe like that. Yeah, I think that'll be fine. And then we're going to get rid of this yard. This yard's not going to be a thing anymore. So we're going to get rid of that. We'll have the corridor that goes there and there. The pathway will come through. Obviously, that will disconnect. Like I said, I kind of want to switch up to a 2-wide path pretty quickly. Oh, that's wrong. That wants to go there. So I want to switch to a 2-wide path pretty quickly, otherwise we're just kind of wasting space with that extra extra wide path. So I think we'll go one more out, and then we'll have something that comes down and probably goes along. Because if we look at the rooms and we look at the prison cell, all prison cells to start with have to be 2x3 wide. So if we go back to planning here, the first sets of prison cells are going to look something like that. They're going to be 2x3 with a door on, and so we want to make sure that we can fit as many of these in as possible, because we get paid per prisoner that we have. We get paid by the prisoner. Also, this is a little bit either too wide or too short, so we are going to have to change that in a second. We'll have that go like that. Do I want that to go, like, end there? I think we will, just because we're a little low on money for now. So we'll have that look like that, and then here we'll have a similar thing going. You know, we'll have like a 3x2 cell here. So 1, 2, 3. It's gonna have to look something like that, and then we'll have like just a bunch of cells on this side that are mirroring, kind of mirroring the cells on this side, but not quite. You can see like the doors are a little bit offset. Maybe the prisoners are gonna like it. You know, you can't see directly into somebody else's cell, although I don't think it really matters all that much, nonetheless. So we'll have that there. We'll have the pathway come up here. And then maybe go like across? I'm not quite sure how I want this to look. Do I want that to go up there, or do I want to have this kind of like go maybe up through here? And don't have that? Just have that be like a wall? You know, I kind of like that. I kind of like that. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to have that there. I'm going to have this come up through here. At this point, I think we're going to have a shower. So let me get my planning back out. And I'm pretty sure we're going to have like a shower that also functions as a pathway. Like, you're gonna have to go through the shower to get where you wanna go. And so what I'm thinking is, 1, 2, 3, yeah, we'll have like a cell there. Our prisoners have arrived. Here they are. Look, this is the jail bus. They are here. We got Busby. We got whoever this guy is. Why is he wearing black? Stefan? Trolley Car Steve Lanquiz. I completely butchered that last name, I'm sure. Pushed a fat man off a bridge and into the path of a trolley car with no brakes, saving 5 workers who were at the end of the track, but killing the fat man. His appeal to the court, better that one dies and save 5 lives. Okay, I mean, I don't know if that's unsound logic, but he's in prison anyway for it. Maybe that's why he's in black, because he kind of broke the law, but saved some people doing it. And then we've got, I'm not even going to try this name, we've got Nika, or Nika, who is sentenced for 6 years for kidnapping. We got Forrest, 3 years for driving under the influence. We got Gray, who is just like turned up in his Jamas, or what the heck is this? Casper Knuckles Gray, convicted for child cruelty, child endangerment, depriving children of food, selling children as food? Ah, that's disgusting. What a guy. And then we got this guy over here, Matt Steele. Mr. Steele himself. Oh, what a guy. All right. Luckily, we're not flipping it. We need to hire more staff right off the get-go here. Flipping, hire another guard. Get these guys in. Like, we don't want them just standing outside here, just wandering around doing nothing. But anyway, back over to the planning here. We're going to put a cell there, but then this is going to be like the shower area. So I'm going to have another cell on this side here like that. So we have two cells either side of what's going to be the shower. So you're going to be able to walk kind of right through the shower, but then we're going to have the shower here. The reason why I'm doing it like this, the reason why I want it to be kind of a walkthrough shower, is that I've built showers before like this one, and people just cram at the doorway. They don't disperse as you would expect them to disperse. They just all try and go for the closest shower, and then they all get crumpled together, and they all get annoyed and hot and bothered, and they start to riot, and it's not great. They kill each other, and they attack each other, and it's not pleasant. So I'm going to try and make this as like wide open as possible. It's not quite as efficient as it could be. Like, we got this little bit that's going to obviously end up being like a corridor just to this and this cell, but I think in the long haul it's going to work out pretty nicely. So this is going to be our shower. We're going to have like showers around here, and it's going to look like that. And then up on the top, we'll just kind of mirror, I guess, what we have down here. So we want to have like a two cell. Let's see. Let me make sure this is like the correct width. I think what we're going to end up doing is bringing this in by one like that, which is a little bit annoying because it doesn't line up with this here. It's actually really annoying because it doesn't line up with that there. So you know what? We'll push the showers out by one more like that. The only reason I had it a little shorter is I don't really like this here, but I guess we can also use this as like a way to connect to whatever's going to be connected to this. So the building that's like over on this side is going to connect there, I guess. But we'll do that later on down the line. For now, we'll put that there, get rid of that, bring that wall back, make sure the pathway is too wide, like so. And then here, is this wrong again? What? No, yeah, because we need to have... No, that was right the first time. What the heck are you doing, Isaac? Get rid of that. Get rid of that. Path's going to go along here like that. And then this is going to be what the prison cell looks like. Because you have to have a wall at the front as well. So it's going to look something like this. There we go. And then we'll just kind of mirror what we have here. We'll get rid of that one, that one, that one, that one, and that one. Do I want to, actually looking at it though, do I want to mirror it completely? Do I want to have like a complete mirror of a cell? Do I want to bring it out a bit more so we can fit in these cells? Or, you know what, this is fine. We'll leave this how it is for now. We'll get rid of that. That's obviously going to be the pathway as well. But I kind of like this. I don't want to make it too big because, again, we've only got 28,000. Our administrative cell is on its way. We have unlocked a bureaucracy now. Those 5 hours are through, and so we can go ahead and hire an accountant who is going to go ahead and take one of these offices right off the bat. And also, we do want to put a staff door right about there so someone can actually claim that office. But we just completed another grant, which is pretty cool. And now we will set up another big concrete building that looks something like that. And we will also, I guess, simultaneously clear all of these fences. Like, we built this yard just to get rid of it straight away. To instantly get rid of it. So we'll hit play. This is the jail door, so they shouldn't be allowed out of this jail door now because they don't have any yard time. We do have a scheduler. We can, schedule what the prisoners do. Regime here. So right now, they're mostly in lockup. They have a bit of shower time. We do want to get rid of their yard time. For now, yard time is just going to be lockup time. There's not really any point in them having free time right now because there's nothing for them to do. They can shower and they can eat. That's all they can do. So we will add another breakfast. Like, we'll eat at 9 and then we'll push this to like 1 to 2. Does that look good? Because I do think they should be eating 3 times a day. If you feed them too little or like low quality food, they do get pretty annoyed. But for now, we'll leave that like that. We'll get building this new cell. We'll speed it up a little bit so they can actually start to build this thing. What is up with the lights? Is it just fog of war? I think it might be. I think we can't see in here because we don't have any guards in there. I wonder, we're almost done with maintenance. I would like, let me cancel some of these. I want to force security to be the next one we unlock because unlocking the security like section allows us to deploy our guards where we want them to be. So I can say that I want one of our guards to be in this holding cell at all times. Right now, they're just, look at what are they, why are you sort of what, like doping around in deliveries? They are not doing anything whatsoever. They're not watching the prisoners. They're just kind of sitting around. And so I do want to make sure that we can get security pretty quick. We don't have power running to any of our utilities in the kitchen, which means we've brought them all to the cafeteria, and there is just no food whatsoever for them to eat. So we'll do something. Do I have to go round for this? Do I have to do, like, that? I'm not quite sure if you have to actually connect to this or just to the, like, the utility itself. But we'll put that down. Guys, don't worry about it. Come 1 or 2 p.m. when lunch is around. You guys can actually eat. But, like, right now, I would like to have a guard in here so that I can actually see what they're doing. I don't have a clue what these six prisoners are up to because this person is complaining that they're tired. Look at this guy. Just complaining about stuff. Flipping heck. All right, look at this. We've got our new wing. Looks great. I didn't want to do that. I wanted to change. Let me change this. I want to have a wall there and there, and then I want to bulldoze those two. I don't want that either to be a thing. Can I, like, bulldoze that? I can. Let's bulldoze this and this, because I don't want that to be a thing, and I don't want that to be a thing. But we do want to make sure we have walls here and here, and then we can start building the walls. They're going to make up the cells, like so. And then once this is done, we are going to have capacity for what? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, possibly 15 prisoners. And that looks pretty good to me. That's a fairly nice size, a fairly nice starting prison. At that point, we might get away with the facilities we have now with a 15-man prison. But we are going to have to upgrade pretty quickly because our cafeteria is not built to be able to hold 15 people. We do have a new shower plan, so that's fine. Which is good because this shower probably could handle 15 people, but not with this little door. They would again get cramped and they'd start, like, complaining and rioting, and it wouldn't be good. It would not be good. So let's do this. Once that's done, we can start putting down some actual cells. We can just quick build, and we can pick just a basic cell, which is just a bed and a toilet with a door on. So boom, 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 and boom. We'll also do, I guess, boom and boom, because we have six prisoners right now. That is quite a lot of our money down. We're on 17,000 still, which is good. And we haven't, oh my goodness, why? Did we overload the power? All right, we've got a capacitor. Let's put down one, and then let's buy like two more as well, just to kind of future-proof a little bit, because right now we have nothing working. We can't see our prisoners. What is going on right now? What is going on? We're 4.5 hours away from being able to tell our guards to do their jobs, but that's fine. I think we have enough guards for now. We've got three guards for six prisoners. Last time I played, a bunch of people did, like, tell me that I should have half as many guards as prisoners. So if we have 10 guards, we should have... Oh, if we have 5 guards, we should have 10 prisoners, or 20 prisoners, 10 guards, like that. I don't know if that's necessarily, like, the case when you get into the late game, once you get, like, CCTV and you can watch prisoners remotely. I don't think you need quite that many guards, but definitely in the early game, I think having twice as many prisoners as guards is a good idea, because they can outnumber you really quickly. We are going to have to run some utilities over here. Let's get some basic pipes. Again, I want to make sure that we don't have any large pipes going to cells. Like, I don't like what we have here, and so I'm going to be active on this. I'm going to reroute my pipes right off the get-go. I'm actually going to dismantle these pipes. I'm pretty sure the last time I played, I did not dismantle a single pipe, but for now, we're going to get rid of all of these. We're going to dismantle all those pipes, and we're going to run normal pipes to all the cells. We're going to make sure that they cannot possibly try and escape using the big tunnels like this. That's not at all what we want to happen. Does that need to go one more out? It might do. I can't remember if we got rid of that. But we're taking those away. We'll run this up to there. That looks good. The extra capacitors are down? Yeah, so let's turn this back on. There we go. All right, cool, 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 cool. Wow, even with the new... Oh, we haven't even got these capacitors in yet. Okay, where are all my capacitors at? Flipping, we need to hire some more workmen. We're only making $790 a day, but you know what? We'll bump it up to 10 workmen right off the bat here. We do also, again, want to make sure that we put down lights probably in every single cell like this. And then also probably in, like, the hallways every so often as well. So we'll put, like, one there, we'll have, like, one there. Yeah, that's fine for now. We'll put some in what is going to be the shower right there. Well, we will actually allocate this as the shower as well. We'll do that. So you can walk through if you want to get to it. We're going to have drains kind of just running along the middle like this, so that if you do walk through, you're not going to be walking in water. There's not going to be any water here. But we are going to have shower heads kind of just all around like that. Whoa, what are those sounds about? Look at this! Look at this! They're unconscious! Why? Are these capacitors down? They are. Okay, so look at that. We got much more power now. But look at this! Someone has already been attacked! Because our guards... And look at this! Our flippin' workman's been injured as well! What is this? Why has this guy been bumped up to maximum security already? Wow! So we took in 6 minimum security prisoners, and already one of them has been bumped up to maximum security, probably for knocking this guy unconscious and attacking this guard. We desperately need to hire a doctor, I guess. We can't do that until security is done, at which point we can unlock health. But we need to get a doctor to help this guy. Otherwise, there's not much we can do. Why? You know what? It's bang up. Lockdown. No, bang up. Everyone, get in your cells. Go to your cells until we get stuff sorted out. Flipping heck. So, bang up sends everyone back to the cells. Lockdown closes every single door in the area. And then shakedown searches the entire prison. So, for now, this is fine. We'll just lock everybody up until we get things under control. Let's run this cable along like that and then up through the shower. That's probably safe. And then we'll run this up as well like that. And we'll connect up all the shower heads using smaller pipes like so. And we should have dismantled some of the other shower heads before putting these ones down. But you know what? We can do that now. We can get rid of all of the stuff in here. We don't need any of these shower heads anymore. All of these can go. And we will actually undersign this as a shower room. Get rid of that entirely. And we'll change this into something else later on down the line. I also don't really think we're going to keep the holding cell. We'll probably change that to be like a reception at some point. And also, we do not want to accept more prisoners tomorrow. We want to fill the capacity at most. So we'll take one new prisoner, and all of our prisoners are going to be medium sec for the time being. So that's all good. Yeah, I don't really think we're going to keep the holding cell. Holding cells don't really serve a whole lot of purpose. They allow you to hold prisoners before you put them somewhere. But if we're only going to take prisoners in when we have capacity for them, we don't really need to hold them. We might need a holding cell later on if we get like an event that gives us a bunch of prisoners. But I think for the time being, we'll just get rid of the holding cell and put like a reception there or something. This guy is awake again. He is injured. We do need to get a doctor still, but we'll keep him down there. We're going to have to get a maximum security wing pretty soon because this guy, he's already in maximum security. He's already attacked people. So that's going to be something we have to do. This is not hooked up. This is not dismantled. Get rid of you. The new showers are up and running. We have boxed up all of those shower heads. So let's put some of those down around on this side. So we've got 9 spare shower heads. Let's put those down in here like so. And yeah, it looks fine for now. You know, it's not a massive shower. We can only hold, what, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9? And I want to change that to there. We can only hold like 18 prisoners in this shower. But again, it'll be fine for now. We'll probably have a shower for each like cell block. In the past, I've made the mistake of having one, like a whole prison sharing one shower, which is not the way to go. It ends up in riots every single time. And so we're probably going to end up with a lot more showers than we've had in the past. We are running out of money pretty quickly. But I'm fairly certain there is a grant to build a medical ward, right? Prison inmate health and well-being. Build a medical ward, hire at least 2 doctors, and hire a psychologist. I think we will take that. Cell block A wants us to have at least 15 capacity. We will also take that out as well because that's a lot of money. And we have exactly the right amount of room for 15 cells. So, you know, we will actually go to the quick build. We'll grab the basic cell and we will put down the remainder of our basic cells. I guess we're going to move. We'll put a wall there instead of there. And we'll do that there. And then we'll switch this around. And we'll do the same thing over here. We'll just move where the wall is and where the door is. But here we go. Oh, I don't want to do that. That was wrong. And that was wrong as well. How did I make 2 mistakes at once? Okay, let's pause real quick. Let's unassign those 2. They haven't put down any items by the looks of things. So that's fine. We do want to make sure we have lights again in every single one of these cells. Like so. And then we'll put one like there. And there as well. We want to make sure we get the walls in as well. So we'll put walls. Yeah, they're putting walls in for us. Cool. Cool, cool, cool. And also, they've kind of automatically just not put anything in there. We want to make sure that small pipes are running all the way along there. We will run the large pipe. Actually, no, we'll just run this like that. Because, again, I do not want any large pipes in anybody's cells whatsoever. So we'll just leave that like that. Run that along like that. And this is looking good. This is looking pretty good. We'll go over to quick build, clone. We'll grab, actually, we gotta wait until these are finished. But once they're finished, we can just grab this guy's stuff. We'll grab that guy's stuff, and we will put it there, there, and there. Beautiful. All right, once all that's done, we should have a new prisoner capacity of 15, which will complete that grant and give us $20,000 extra. Build a medical ward, hire at least 2 doctors, and hire a psychiatrist. We can't hire 2 doctors until that's done. Once that's done, we'll start working on psychology. We have, however, unlocked the guard here. Not the guard, the chief. So we'll throw down the chief. He should take this office. We do need to make sure that these officers down here are connected up with some power. So let's just go ahead and run that down like so. But now that we have the chief, we should be able to... Oh, do we have to unlock deployment after the chief? Oh, we do. Okay, we'll do that. The good thing is that the warden isn't in charge of deployment. All of the stuff coming off of these people is the responsibility of these people. So if I wanted to unlock, for example, extra grants so that we could take out 3 grants instead of 2, the accountant would do that, not the warden. So you'll see that this is also going down whilst we're also researching doctors as well, which is good because I want to be able to deploy my guards to certain areas of the prison wherever possible. We currently have 12 cells. Why is that? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Why did you put bricks there? What is this? I know we used the... What is this? We used like the clone tool, but I don't want brick walls just randomly in my prison. Flippin' egg. These are not classified because they don't have doors. That's why. Okay, so that is going to be 13, 14, and then 15 is this one over here. So quick build. Let's again clone. Let's just grab this cell. Plunk it down right there. All right, cool. Once all that stuff's done, that should be all 15 cells, and that should be the grant complete. Let's hit play so stuff starts to happen. We'll probably, for the time being, we have to have a medical ward. So we'll have, like, an infirmary here with some medical beds and the doctors. We'll have an extension built down here so that the psychiatrist can actually have an office because he doesn't need an office. So let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, I think. 1, 2, 3, 4, and then wall. I think that's right. That should be right. So here we go. These guys are building stuff. We do need to replace the walls we just took down with concrete walls. So that one and that one. And then once that's done, we should be good to go. We should have completed that cell block here. We have capacity for 15 prisoners. We are going to take in a lot of prisoners tomorrow. We're probably going to bring that up to 15. Which should be fine in terms of like the shower, in terms of the space. The canteen is going to struggle with 15 people, mostly just due to the size. I don't think the chefs are going to struggle producing food for 15 people. I think mostly just the size of the canteen is not big enough for 15 people. And so we're probably going to want to set up like another block over here, or maybe even like down here, and maybe just expand downwards. That's going to be just like a big canteen, because canteens are one of the biggest things that we need, both like in terms of their importance in the game and also their physical size. They need to be big. We do have 15 cells now though, so that is done. How are we doing in terms of unlocking health? That is approved, so we can go ahead and hire 2 doctors right off the bat. There we go. And so now we need to build a medical ward. We do want to get psychiatry unlocked pretty quickly. That is on its way. Rooms, where is infirmary? Infirmary's right there. Kapow. This requires to be indoors and a medical bed, so we will put down, we'll put a staff door on there, because prisoners can go through staff doors, but they have to be escorted by a guard, and we don't want prisoners just walking into the infirmary willy-nilly. We want them to be escorted by a guard if they are going to go into the medical ward here. And then we'll just put down some medical beds for now. We'll put like one there. And then annoyingly, again, it doesn't fit in the middle. So for now, we're just going to have like 2 there. And then I guess like, you know what? 2 is fine. For now, we'll just have 2. We might like break down this wall and make this one big infirmary later on down the line, because we can need a lot of space. At that point, we'll move the medical bed and try and fit in as many as we can symmetrically. But for now, 2 people can fit in there. That should be fine. We got 52,000. We're only making $370 a day because we've just hired some doctors and the new guard, and we're going to hire a new psychiatrist. So we're hiring a lot of people. This is not at all how this should be. That needs to look something like that. And at that point, we can just grab ourselves the clone tool and do something like that. Yeah, do something like that. Boom. That's going to be the new psychiatrist's office in 4 hours when he's done. And come 8 a.m., we are going to have 8 new prisoners arriving to fill in those cells. Now, that's not going to quite take us up to 15. I think that's probably just because, yeah, there are no more than 8 available. The game is not going to give us more than 8. We could take 10 if we allowed minimum security guys in as well. The reason I'm not taking minimum security guys is they pay less. And again, I don't want to mix and match. So you get $300 for every minimum security guy, $500 for every medium, and then $1,000 for every maximum. So maximum are worth a lot more and minimum worth a lot less. But they're also, like, maximum's a lot harder, minimum's a lot easier, but medium's kind of where we want to be for the time being. Eventually, as our prison gets bigger and we have more funds and we're able to build more cell blocks, we'll have, like, a dedicated area for maximum security. They'll have their own canteen, their own place to do their thing. You know, medium security will also have their place, and then minimum security will have theirs as well. We might even get a place for a supermax, because some of my... Flipping, we need to get deployment. How far is that away from being done? 2 hours, because I cannot see what these prisoners are doing. They could be tunneling out. You know what? We're going to have a shakedown. We should turn bang up off. I bet my prisoners are not happy. Yeah, the danger level is rising because my prisoners are not happy, mostly because they've been locked up for a whole day here. Let's see. We'll hire some more guards here. We'll jump up to, I guess, like, six, seven, maybe? You know what? Yeah, seven. I don't want to go too many because we are dangerously close to losing money on a daily basis. But I do want to make sure that we have about, like I said, half as many prisoners as we do, half as many guards as we do prisoners. So we'll leave that there. We're almost done with the psychologist. We'll speed things up a little bit. We'll go to 3x speed and watch these guys just go around, check all these prisons out. We want to make sure no one's trying to dig out. They shouldn't be able to. I have no idea where he got a baton from. Probably one of our police officers. But they shouldn't have any of the tools required to escape. Like, we don't have a workshop, so I don't think they're going to have a pickaxe. They haven't had any visitation rights, so they can't have smuggled something in through somebody else. There is almost no way of them getting anything unless they took it off one of our guards. All right, everything's clear. This is what I want it to look like. I want to be able to see what's going on in my prison at all times. But until we could deploy our guards, that's not going to happen. So we are kind of playing the waiting game now, waiting for these two to run out. Deployment is almost done. It's 40 minutes away. So we will just wait 8 more seconds. And then once that is done, we get this little tab down here. So now we can have guard patrols. We can't have guard patrols yet. We have to unlock patrols separately. Oh, we do. Okay, patrols, get those unlocked as well. But what we can do is we can station guards in specific places. So if we go to deployment, we can make sure that there are like always two guards in this block here. The reason why it's classified as a block is because there are no like dividing walls like there is here. So we want to have guards in here at all time, making sure the prisoners are not getting up to any shady stuff. I want to have a guard in the canteen. We'll have a guard in just the hallway here. And no one should be in the holding cell, so we shouldn't need to have a guard there. But you know what? Boom, we'll have one there anyway. Okay. We've got good eyes on our prison. Do we want to have a guard up here? You know what? We will do just in case. We've got all of our guards. All of them look like they've got stuff to do now. So it says 0 out of 7 are free, which is not good because in about an hour, we're going to have all of our new inmates arriving. This guy is just resting on the floor here. We should really get a staff room up and running. You know, let's get rid of this deployment. No, I want to get rid of that one and that one. And you know what? I don't know if these guys are going to go to the prisoners, or they're going to stay on their patrols. I think that as soon as the new prisoners arrive, I think they will go and try and get them. Possibly. I hope. We'll find out. We got 30 minutes until our new prisoners arrive. How are we looking? Psychology is approved, so let's go ahead and hire a psychologist. You can go, what is happening with this office? Every time I come back, something is just massively wrong with it. 1, 2, 3, 4. So yeah, that one's to go there, and then that will be an office. There is no power going to that office, so we'll run this a little bit further down like that. We want to make sure it has a light in, so we'll put one of those right about there. It is raining now. This is kind of the weather taking effect. You can see right now it's 8 degrees Celsius, 47 Fahrenheit. That's the current temperature. It's not too cold just yet. They should be fine. Although if it does get significantly colder, which it doesn't look like it's going to. It looks like it's getting a little bit warmer. But if it does get significantly colder than 9, we do want to start working on that. What is this missing? Minimum size 4x4? Oh, I see. It's just not quite set up right. Where is office? There it is. Not quite set up right. There we go. Boom. Okay. Did we hire a psychologist? We did not. Hired. He's going to work in there. That's another grant complete. We've now got $61,000. All of our new inmates have just arrived. Look at that. They're getting sent to their cells. These ones are just kind of chilling out here. They want their clothes washed. We do need to set up some kind of laundry area. That is a thing that we need to do. It looks like the guards are not going to come away from their patrols whatsoever, which I guess is a good thing. The doctors are tired. The guards are tired. The prisoners are probably not too tired. They've just had a good night's sleep. We do need to get a staff room. We need to get laundry. We need to get a better infirmary. There is so much stuff that we still need to do in this game. But for now, guys, I'm going to end this first episode of Prison Architect. There, we got a nice prison. We got a 15 capacity. We got 14 prisoners. We got a basic canteen. We got basic stuff up and running. We got a little bit of a cell block down here. We do need to get some cleaners and some gardeners in as well, because this place is a mess. But this is only the beginning. Next time we'll come back, we'll expand, we'll do some more stuff. We'll make our prison the best prison that it could possibly be. But for now, guys, thanks for watching. If you did enjoy the video, be sure to hit a like. It really does help out a lot. Leave a comment down below, and I will see you guys next time.